zombie stat drugs. But should they be? Here's what we know. The Cochrane database, that's the gold standard, where they get the best people in the world on a particular subject. They study it out and give us their advice. Their advice a few years ago was, it's questionable whether we should give people statins just to lower their blood cholesterol when they don't have any heart disease. That was the first big step. In 2013, in their revision of who should be on statins, they said people older than 75 should not be on statins. Why? Well, the older people with higher levels live longer, that's why. They never talked about it, but the studies have been made, three studies of just women. And women who take the statins to lower their blood cholesterol level die sooner than those who don't. So what's the problem here? What's the problem? Now, the big thing just came recently. There was a study of 11 different studies. They reviewed these 11 different studies, and they found out for 93% of the people on statins, they didn't increase their life expectancy any at all. Those are the people who didn't have heart disease, but they were just giving it to lower their blood cholesterol. Now, 7%, it did help. They lived 8.25 years longer, but those were the people who already had heart disease. Our problem, according to the leading authorities that I counseled with on the subject, the problem is we can't tell really who has heart disease. Only the people who have heart disease should be taking this statin medicine, not just to lower blood cholesterol if they don't have heart disease. But to do that, we would have to do CAT scans of the heart, of the coronary arteries, to see who has calcified coronary arteries. Then we would know who had heart disease. But that takes trained physicians to do it. We don't have enough trained to do it. We can do it, but we don't have enough to do it. There's two doctors in San Francisco doing it. They're training groups of doctors all the time. The insurance company in the United States will not pay for this. It's expensive. It costs us $950 to have a patient go through this process. So this is the problem with statins. So the World Journal of Cardiology came out last year with, what should we tell our patients about statins? They said we should tell them the truth. That when we thought that if we would lower serum cholesterol, we would do away with heart disease, that thought was inaccurate. That was erroneous. That is not true. So what should we tell them? We should tell them that what really benefits them is lifestyle. Avoid those major risk factors. Primordial prevention of heart disease, not smoking, cutting out the alcohol, exercising, keeping the weight down, eating more like a vegetarian, and maybe avoiding high blood pressure. And that those same five will do that. And avoid the high serum cholesterol, and those same five will.